Wrestling Soup is now joined by James Ellsworth, a.k.a. Jimmy Dean. How's it going, Jimmy?
Hey, man, I was digging the Offspring intro there.
Yeah, you're like a huge Offspring guy, too, right? Like, I mean, obviously you have the tattoo, clearly. But, I mean, like, you go to the concerts and stuff like that?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. My favorite band, so I go to all the every time they're in the area.
They were actually one of my first bands I ever saw, like, I think in 1998, 99. How long have you had the ink done for?
Since I was 18, so yeah, about 13 years now.
Nice.
Yeah, that sounds about right. Yeah, that's right around the time where they were fucking hitting their second stride there when they went away for a while and then came back again.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
But anyways, man, this has been a big month for you, huh?
Yeah, it's been overwhelming to say the least.
You got a lot of love coming in. There's a lot of people, a lot of responses and stuff like that. When we put it up, I made a nice little graphic for you. It was a little art noir. And I think I got some flack for it because they're like, are you guys doing the show in French? And I'm like, no. I thought it was kind of a nice change because everybody's looking at the guy and they're like, oh, he's the enhancement talent guy. But there was a lot of love, a lot of good questions thrown towards your way. And obviously a lot of interesting questions as well, man.
Good. I'm glad we're not doing the show in French. I don't know anything about French. Not even like that little kiss thing. I have no clue.
All right. I have one quick question before I get into something. But so you've obviously seen a whole shit ton of memes. Do you have a favorite one so far? Have you seen one that's so far stuck out the most to you?
I mean, there was one where I was like the little engine that could and. It said the little jobber that could, and had like my face and my little hands in the air. And then I saw a really neat one today, a new one that said WWE hashtag We Want Ellsworth. I thought that was pretty neat.
Yeah.
For the people that might not know you, because we probably should have started out with this, but you know, for the people that might not know you, want to tell people just a story real quick of how you've ended up becoming like this, you know, meme, basically like this recognizable name in wrestling out of fucking nowhere over the last week and a half. You want to just fill people in, let them know what happened?
Well, I wrestled Braun Strowman on Raw, and I woke up the next day and there was thousands of memes of my face everywhere. just like that. It was crazy.
Now, how did you end up getting that spot? Did you just get called in for extra work down there, or did you have any idea when you got there that day that you were going to be working?
No, not at all. I mean, I've been an extra for a couple of years now at WWE, and they call me usually every time they're like within 250 miles of Baltimore where I live, and I had no clue once I got to the building that night that I would be wrestling on the show at all, no.
Yeah, that's funny how that works out for certain guys. Like, you know, a couple of the same people that I know, and a lot of them, they just end up going to the venue. They're just eating catering. They have no fucking clue that, or, you know, they have no idea whether they're going to be working or whether they're just going to be hanging out, you know, eating on the company dime. But no, man. So what happened? How did it go about them picking you to be the guy to have this match?
Well, it's really cool, man. Arn Anderson came and wanted all the extras around ringside, and we're all standing there. And he just comes up to me. He goes, let me see you throw a punch on one of these other guys. I said, okay. So I threw a punch on one of the other extras. And he said, you know, okay, that's not bad at all. And I said, I appreciate it. You know, thank you. Coming from him, of course. That was a great compliment. And he said, get in the ring. And I said, okay. And I got in the ring, and he said, let me see you throw a punch on Strowman. I said, okay. I just walked up and threw the punch. And he was like, kid, good. He's like, you know, work a little, you know, put together a little match with him. I didn't know he was talking about for Raw. I said, okay. He said, we're together this little match. He's like, are you comfortable with all this? I said, yeah, I'm comfortable with it. And he said, all right, we're going to put it on TV tonight. And I was like, all right, cool. Like, I mean, I'm very business-like when I go up there. I've been wrestling 14 years, so it was all business. You know, obviously there was nerves and everything, but I just try to be as business-like as possible, especially around Arn Anderson.
Did you get the same $1,000 deal that the guy on the week after did?
I mean, I got paid very well. That's good. I obviously won't put a number out there.
Right, yeah.
Paid better than I've ever been paid up there before. So that was very, very, another thing that was very humbling is my paycheck. I was very humbled by it.
More than your average indie show? I don't believe that. I don't know about that.
Who did you hang out with when you were up there?
I mean, the other extras. One of my friends referees for WWE, so I was hanging out with him. Simon Gotch, like, interestingly enough, was talking to me a lot. I don't know. I'm hanging out with him.
I've known it's been an interesting couple of weeks for him too. So
yeah,
but yeah, man, that's pretty cool. I mean, that's a random thing that a lot of guys, like I said, they go into it, they have no clue what's going to happen, and now you've kind of become this quick overnight phenomenon.
Absolutely.
But yeah. But I will say this, and I wanted to throw this out here. We do have some very nice, normal questions, obviously.
Yes.
But this is the internet. So clearly we left some we left the forum open for people, and I compiled 10 of easily the meanest fucking questions people asked you.
I can't wait to hear them.
All right, are you prepared for this?
Oh, nothing bad's ever written on the internet. So I know it can't be too bad.
All right. I'll do the pleasure.
I'm actually looking forward to it, believe it or not.
Hey, man, and no news, or what should I say? No press is bad press, I guess you could say.
Absolutely, as long as they're talking, I don't care. I'm 100% honest.
Anything that makes you stand out in wrestling. Okay, ready? All right, Mish, I'll do the honors.
Go for it.
Number one, do you ever get angry with God knowing that some people get two chins and you weren't even granted one?
Actually, I lost my chin in a fire saving a cat.
Shit.
Okay, we're gonna need more on that story. But okay, all right, on to number two.
No, he's referencing from last week, man.
What happened? Oh. Well,
yeah. I'm like, how did he lose his chin? Did he lose it in a fire or something?
Oh,
shit.
Okay. All right. Number two. God. Do you hate it when you get neck burns from eating extra hot cheese pizza? Meaning that I guess that means, like, while you're eating the pizza, your chin, it burns your chin.
I only hate my pizza when it's late. Like, I can't stand, like, when the pizza dude's late. Like, you ever watch Ninja Turtles and the pizza guy was late? And so, other than that, no, nothing about pizza bothers me.
As long as it's there, right?
There you go.
Yeah.
All right. Is it difficult or just outright impossible for you to fold towels or sheets?
I don't wonder. You know, I'm actually a very lucky man. My girlfriend handles all of that. So, yeah, that dude that answers that question can eat shit, because I know he probably doesn't have a girlfriend. He's never been touched by a woman in his life.
See, now that's the right response.
There you go.
All right, so we're almost there. All right, number four. Are you, in fact, the living antonym of a Chinese phone book?
Yes.
See, right, succinct, right to the point, shit. Perfect. All right, number five is actually that. Now this one, it's like these people knew a little bit. They knew about BTW Pro, so I got to throw this one out there. Okay, have you ever wrestled Matt Hardy before? Seeing as your chin has obviously been deleted.
Actually, I have wrestled Matt Hardy, and maybe that's where it went. I'm gonna call later.
he's hiding it down there on the what does he call it? His compound,
yes.
Or something.
Oh my God, who knows? I think that whole thing is fucking great. But
yeah,
right, so, it's awesome.
All right, so number six, we're almost there. All right, are you immune to all super kicks or merely the sweet chin music?
Well, anything chin breaker, chin lock, all those moves, like, they don't work on me. I just get around.
Well, this is on a side note. Now, if this becomes some sort of a thing for you, maybe you can steal how Joey Ryan does everything with his dick. You are immune to chin-based stuff.
That'd be great. Whatever gets over.
That's awesome.
Wouldn't be bad at all. All right, so number seven. Were you triggered by the sentiments of the three little pigs towards the big bad wolf?
Not by the hair on my chinny chin chin. The reference. I do have hair on my whatever it is I have there. Since I have no chin, there is hair there.
Hey, like I said, it's you got to be nervous. Okay, all right. Number eight is kind of. Oh my God! Number eight is kind of a King Kahuna. All right, let's see. If Conor McGregor knocked you out with one punch, Would that qualify as having a glass Adam's apple?
Conor McGregor sucks. Fuck him. I don't want to talk about it. He has no respect for the business.
Ooh. See, now that's something that, like, I know we're going to have to get into that during
totally.
The show this week.
Oh, I would love to, actually.
Yeah, yeah. Like, he's, well, that whole ordeal with him, like, him saying that shit. I mean, I think it's funny the way that the guys responded to it. Like, you could tell the people that the office had said to him, like, oh, you guys got to write a tweet about it, as opposed
right,
to.
Right, yeah, because there were so many of them that did it. So, yeah, it had.
Yeah.
But no, I was a big fan of his before he said all that. Now I'm just like, I'm not even going to watch his fight. Like, I'm just, I don't know. I'm like,
Yeah, but do you think he said it for shock value? Like, he wasn't even fucking serious about it? You think he was just being a dick?
I just don't think he's just, you know, another guy that doesn't get wrestling. I mean, I can't really knock him for it. He probably just doesn't understand it at all. Like, he probably just, oh, it's that fake stuff, and I do the real stuff. That's probably his thinking. But
Well, it's tough, too, because you look at him and you go, did he? I always wondered, I go, did he steal his act from wrestling? Or did he steal it from Chael Sonnen, who stole his act from wrestling?
Good point.
Like, right. I look at the promos and all that.
Yeah. I look at it and I go, okay, did he look at Chael and go, I'll be Chael? Or did he look at wrestling and go, I'll just kind of steal what wrestling does? Like, I think that's the hardest thing about it, is because maybe he really is pulling, like, you know, he's working people and is probably a fan of wrestling or something like that. But if he's not, does he have any clue of how much of the shit that he does is obviously, like, wrestling influenced?
Mm-hmm.
Right. He sells tickets. That's what he does. He, you know, he's in the gift gab. And, but it's same thing. So.
Well, all right. So let's see. We have two left, and these ones I think are pretty. They're pretty standard interview questions. Number nine is how big is Batista's dick?
Well, I guess that's a question that's asked a lot. And you know, when I was cock checking him, I would have to guess. It's like, you know, guessing the raisins in the jar. I'd say about 8 inches.
Oh, that's a reasonable guess. All right. And lastly, after all of those questions, this is the least harsh one. Number 10, what happened to your chin?
I told you I lost it saving a cat in a fire.
Oh. See, were those so bad?
No, they don't bother me a bit, man.
Yeah.
Now, I love it.
Now, we know that, like, outside of WWE, you're doing a lot of stuff. You're running your own promotion down there in Maryland?
Yeah, I run some shows. I run a lot of shows in Maryland with Adrenaline Championship Wrestling, and we also run shows in Pennsylvania as well.
Nice. You guys got Sunny coming up there, I saw.
Yes, August 20th in Denton, Maryland. She'll be there signing autographs and, you know, doing whatever it is Sunny likes to do, I guess.
Oh, yeah.
Sunny did a promo recently, actually, that was, I think she was talking about the show. Do you have that, Mish?
Oh, yeah. Here we go.
All right, this is a recent promo.
Oh, just like that.
Sounds about
right. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. I'm going to come again. Oh, my God. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know what's disturbing about that? The dude. Like, just the way he's making noises.
Yeah, he's a loud dude, isn't he?
Yeah.
Is that we had him on, right?
No. Not that scene.
That wasn't Derek.
He was on the other scene. We had Derek Pierce, one of the guys in your video, but he wasn't in that scene. That scene was actually done by a different gentleman. So
now I know you're using your phone. Did you happen to hear the phantom fart queef on the over the phone there?
I did not.
You didn't? Yeah. Oh my God, Mish, can you isolate?
Sure.
There it is.
That was awesome. That was great.
So my question:
I'm watching that as soon as this call is over.
It was a good standalone flick, not necessarily one for the kiddos, but you know.
Hey man, good for her. She got a good payday for it.
Oh yeah,
whatever. I mean,
her fans love
it. Entertainment too.
Yeah.
So. There's no real way to judge her for that, but. All right, so anyways, this is the big question that I think a lot of people have been wondering. Is there a chance at all, even in the slightest, that we will be seeing more of you on television anytime soon?
I don't know how to answer that. I'll just keep watching. That's all I can say. Just hold it up, hold. Just keep watching. We'll see what happens.
Well, you know what, man? We appreciate the call. We appreciate your time. Now, I want to make sure, though, that you get your plugs in. Are you going to keep going by James Ellsworth, or are you going to go by Jimmy Dream, too, or...?
I think I'm going to stick with the James Ellsworth thing for a while because it's the most, national exposure I've ever gotten under this name. So I'm going to stick with it until if and when it fades away.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, well, this is what you got known for now, man. That's going to be your thing.
How's the overall response been to you, though, since you appeared on Raw?
It's like I said earlier in the interview, it's just overwhelming. I never imagined like this would happen. I literally thought I'd do the match on Raw with Strowman, I'd roll out of the ring afterwards, and just be like all the other enhancement talent they use. Like, they just use guys tonight on SmackDown. Like, you don't hear anything about them afterwards. They're right. I wholeheartedly thought that was going to be me too. And like, it just didn't happen. And it's been great, man. I'm very humbled about it, and I've just loved every minute of it. It's fun. I get a kick out of it. Just those 10 questions you asked me, I got a kick out of that. It's just been very cool.
We have some other listener questions for you, too. Richard Carbone said, if you could have been squashed by anyone else, who would it have been?
If I could have picked my squasher?
Yes.
I think it would have been fun to get my ass kicked by Kevin Owens, I guess. That would have been cool.
There you go.
He's a great worker, and he looked like he could have beat my ass pretty badly. So, yeah, if I were to pick my squasher that night from the people that were there, I would have said Kevin Owens.
Dwayne Relbing brings up, he's like, what was your goal in the wrestling industry?
Well, I mean, believe it or not, and this is going to sound cliche, my dream has always been to wrestle on Monday Night Raw. That was...
Wow.
My goal. It's crazy that it happened. But now that, you reach a goal, you accomplish a goal, then, you don't, just settle with it, I guess. Like, things have changed. Now that I got all this, cool, very unexpected internet publicity, I hopefully can go even farther with it. That's what I'm hoping for. That's the next goal.
Very cool. Tyler Tenacious DeLoa wants to know, how does it feel to be over as Roman Reigns, but with positive reaction?
I hopefully this doesn't get me heat on the internet, but actually I don't, I like Roman Reigns. I'm entertained by him. I just think he was the guy that was pushed down everybody's throat, so that's why he got all his heat.
Right,
and I think now he's doing mid-card stuff, people are going to like him again. My humbled opinion.
Jordan Arnold wants to know, what's your favorite Offspring song?
You're Going to Go Far, Kid. That's my favorite Offspring song. I got so many of them, but that's my absolute favorite.
I think it was Pyro, or was it Self-Destruct or something like that?
They're all good to me, man. I can listen to all their songs all day long.
Matt DiNapoli asks, do you watch Dragon Gate?
I watch... as much wrestling as I can, I'm a fan, man. I love wrestling. Dragon Gate, I have seen some stuff of it, but where I'm at in Baltimore, I don't know if they're on TV or not, but we don't have a channel that they're on, but I have seen some Dragon Gate, yes.
Okay, cool. Been a blast having you on, man.
I appreciate it. It's been fun hanging out with you guys, and your 10 questions is really cool. I guess that's something you guys do every week. It's neat.
I have a question directly from BTW champion Flex Armstrong.
Oh, man, I can't wait.
All right, he wanted to ask, if Sunny were to sit on your face, would she slide right off?
Absolutely not. I have a tongue ring and be like a hook, a fish on a hook.
Well played. Well played.
Nice, man.
Yeah, so, hey, do you want to plug your stuff? And then before you take off, we want to ask you to do a quick plug for the show.
You can find me on Twitter at Real Ellsworth. I just changed that today, actually, the Twitter handle. It's at Real Ellsworth. There are fake ones. That's why it's Real Ellsworth. I hate people. I never was a fan of that either, how people put real, but I understand it now. There are fake Twitters of me. So
you need that Twitter approval. You need that little blue check mark.
I don't think I'm there yet. I don't I will say this, but with all this, I still don't think I'm shit. I just think I got lucky, and hopefully the luck continues. And yeah, like I said, my promotion, Adrenaline Championship Wrestling, you can find us online at adrenalinewrestling.com. You can find me on Facebook, Facebook/James Ellsworth. You find me on Instagram at James Ellsworth Wrestling.
Awesome. That was perfect.
Very cool, James. Thank you very much, man. I appreciate this interview. Absolutely. I think the fans will absolutely be ecstatic to hear from you. Like I said, there's been a huge fucking turnout of positivity. A lot of people wanting to listen to this, and I think everybody will be fucking pleasantly surprised, man. What are you doing tonight? Anything fun?
I'm going to watch. Well, the Orioles are in Oakland, California, playing the A's. They come on 10 o'clock here, so I'm going to lay back and watch the Orioles. And I just, if, I don't know if you're still recording, but I would personally like to tell the fans or anybody who's listening who's supporting me just from the bottom of my heart, thank you very much. I truly appreciate all the love. I never expected in my life that this would happen, and I'm very humble and appreciative about it.